You said you needed our help. This is our chance to do something about it.
I thought we were gonna ride an ice dragon back to back home. Guess not.
Where's Sylvie?
Never trust a fucking wildling.
Did she break free or did someone untie her? Oh, she's seen better days. Poor Mira. Is she gonna die in this episode? The hell's so funny and who's that? Let's look at a bucket. Let people laugh.
Ugh, disgusting.
Rat hole. More disgusting. Can't fit through there.
Rats. They're everywhere in King's Landing.
Yeah. And some of them just look a lot like people. Where's our coal boy? Blood.
Oh, looks fresh. Looks like they didn't make it to the block.
Whoever was standing out there must be the one who was laughing. Probably Cersei. Oh, there's teeth here.
Oh, gods. Those are human teeth.
Yeah, somehow I don't think this is a former dentist office. Nothing else to do, right, other than look at the door. We can look at the torch and get the torch.
No way to get this alight. I wonder if I could use it for something else.
Torch. Alright, mouse wheel for torch. Let's look at the door. Well, I was laughing out there. I was sleeping.
Jailer! Please!
Shut it!
Please come here!
Who's that? Who is that?
I wonder what she's done.
Look at the bar.
How strong are these bars?
Can we really pry that open? Let's talk to her.
hello? excuse me?
What nice, do you want?
Nice day we're having.
Can you get me out of here? Because if not, I don't want to know.
Hey! No talking!
Jailer! Jailer, come over here!
Oh, don't you start again!
Why don't you come here for a moment? We can have a little chat about it.
Gods, woman, I said shut it! Or I will come in there, and you won't like what happens.
Well, what do you want, then? Well, tell me! Please!
He wants you to shut it.
Anything. Just tell me!
That's not shutting it.
Bastard!
Before the day's over, they'll take us straight to the block. So don't give me that look. You can leave the judgment to the Father, whatever gods you believe in.
Don't blame me for trying.
I don't judge you. We've all done things we're not proud of.
I have a son. A little baby boy. I think of the smell of his skin. His tuft of brown hair. There is nothing I wouldn't do. Nothing. Just to hold him again. That's what getting out of here means to me. What would you do in my place?
Where is her son? In King's Landing or elsewhere?
I'll never see him again.
Make your son proud of you.
People will tell your son about you. stories about what you were in life. Give him a story he can be proud of.
But you've no idea what I've done.
That's right.
It doesn't matter what we've done. All that matters now is what we do next.
What can we do? Other than sit here. Oh, here's, what's his name?
Mira, making friends already, I see.
Yep.
Be quick. We'll be coming back for her next. For your trouble.
I didn't get a chance to pry the bar, though. I
what?
Knew that wouldn't work.
Nothing to say.
Block will do that to you.
She's been talking nonstop.
They'll be here for you soon. You don't have much time.
Come to gloat?
What are you doing here, Morgren? Come to rub your triumph in my face.
Far from it, Lady Mira. I've come to make you an offer. I was thinking about what you said. And I've come to the conclusion you're right. Ludd will likely ruin every forest under his control. Only foresters know how to really work ironwood. That's useful.
We both know it.
And then I realized there's something much more valuable than your knowledge of trees, Mira.
Sex?
Your name.
Her name?
I want you as my wife.
Oh. Well, it's part of the deal. Not my idea of
your
courtship.
Wife? Do you do all your wooing in cells? I'm new to courting, but I imagine less violence and intimidation.
Wars are won and lost in the marriage bed, Mira.
That was good.
Kingdoms too. And I want my own kingdom. I'll start with an old and noble house, with a keep like Ironwrath. It may not be the grandest castle in Westeros.
All this marrying stuff to...
But it's a start.
It's not mine to
Marrying me won't help you get Ironwrath. The title belongs to my brother. He's the rightful lord.
I am well aware of the king's law, Mira. You think I haven't thought about that? Two of your brothers are already dead. That idiot Ludd will take care of the rest. One way or another. And it won't take me long to get rid of the harebrained fool myself. I'm sorry, Mira. None of your family will survive. Ironwrath will fall to you. And through marriage, it will become mine. A holdfast in the north can only help my ambitions.
Kill you in your sleep.
Until I cut your throat in your sleep.
Doubtless you'd try, given half the chance. But you won't be. It's fitting our betrothal begins in a cell. I'd say it's a perfect symbol for the rest of your life.
You plan to keep me locked up?
Well, perhaps not literally. If you play your part and produce my heirs.
No way.
The murder of a Lannister guard can't go unpunished. But I can get you out of here, Mira. One word from me, that coal boy takes your place on the block.
Oh no!
Tom.
All you have to do is agree to marry me. You'll give up your power, you'll give up your ancestral home, but you'll be alive.
So you're gonna marry him and kill the coal boy.
So, Mira, what do you say?
Even just one of those things is horrible. I'm probably killing her right now. Never.
You will never have Ironwrath. And you will never have me.
What? You fool.
I'd rather die.
You probably killed her.
Fine. Have it your way.
Oh boy. I'm sorry, Mira. Crap. I'm gonna feel horrible no matter what
she
choice
won't get
I make.
Far. Not out here.
Sylvie!
Oh.
He's my brother! I wasn't finished!
Where's Finn?
When you're finished here, come see me. There's something I must show you.
Where's Cotter?
I don't trust these people, Gared.
Which is why I had to see Cotter. He's not well. And he won't live much longer.
I need to see him.
I need to see him. Is he in there?
There's a reason I wanted to talk to you. I need you to do something for me. I didn't want him to suffer anymore, Gared. Just to ease his pain, but... That's when they found me. The Nightshade. I need you to be the one to end his suffering.
Oh my gosh, so I'm gonna poison him.
It's our way, Gared. You have to feed it to him. I'm trusting you to do this, Gared. You're the only one who can.
Okay.
I will. You can trust me. I'll do the right thing.
Thank you, Gared. He's in so much pain.
All this poison. And marriages. I just call this episode Marriages and Poison. Forward. How you doing? What's up? What you doing?
I did everything within my power to help your friend. But I'm afraid it's too late. Nothing can save him now.
Sylvie told me.
Nightshade? What are you going to do with that?
And his suffering?
You realize it's deadly. And has no place in here.
What were you doing to him?
What are you doing with that knife?
It's meant for you.
What? For me to use it or to put in me? Everything's all shaky.
Is that you? It's me, Cotter.
Frame rate's good though.
I'm here. Where's Sylvie?
Ooh, that's not good.
I want to see her. Where is she? Did something happen to her?
She sent me here.
Don't worry. She's right outside. She sent me to help you. I thought they took her away. To help Sylvie. Cotter. Oh, I can't bear it anymore.
He's been incredibly brave. A lesser man would have died days ago. But I suppose you already knew that about him.
He's a strong man.
He's a fighter. Always has been.
I can see that. But now you can use his death to give his life meaning.
Huh?
This was always intended for my father. It's a sacred symbol of the power of the North Grove. Forged from iron. The handle made with ironwood from this very tree. In my father's absence, you speak for House Forrester. It seems only right that you should have this now.
What are we doing with this?
You're here for a reason, Gared. It's no accident they sent you.
It's a tremendous honor.
I'm honored. Thank you.
It's well deserved. Your friend is dying. But his life is too valuable to waste.
What does she mean?
Give me his heart.
What?
His beating heart. And his death can have meaning. We can use it for a greater purpose, Gared.
An ancient ritual to help harness the power of the North Grove.
But
we must do this, Gared.
I fear what might happen if we don't.
Out of your mind, what?
Beating heart. This is madness.
Not madness. Necessity. Madness would be letting the North Grove fall. You saw what happened after the fight. My warriors, they're pulling away. Please, I need you to do this. For me, for the North Grove.
He knows, right?
Any longer.
This is okay with him?
End his suffering. Use his life to make us strong, Gared.
I mean, he can hear everybody.
Give him that poison, and his blood will be useless. Let us use his blood to give us strength. Out there, you saw what's possible. That was only the beginning.
No time limit, I'll just listen to her for a sec.
Perform the ritual, and we can prepare for the coming winter.
Then will you help Iron Wrath?
Oh, he glitched.
Yeah, let's do the blood magic thing. I hope it won't give him any more pain than he's already in, like, prolong it.
I'll do it.
I knew I could count on you, Gared. Use a dagger to open his chest.
Oh my god.
We need his heart.
It's gonna be nasty. You ready, guys? Oh my god.
Good. Now grab his heart. Quickly. While his blood still pulses through it.
Alright. Yeah. Oh, crap, we gotta hold it.
Now bring it here.
Alright, bring
it. Squeeze the blood into the fire.
Squeeze the blood in the fire.
While it's still warm.
This is nasty, guys. Let's squeeze that.
Svobula.
That worked, I hope.
Thank you, Gared. I know it was difficult.
Yeah, and I'll be traumatized
for
life.
You did the right thing.
Now help us.
Now we must burn the body.
Okay. Poor Cotter. At least his suffering's over. My god. The people who came with us on this trip, they're both dead. You realize that, right? We doomed them.
The wine is ready, my lord. Your sister will pour. Once they're all seated, give the signal.
Remember, no matter how much they might provoke you, we must let them think they've won.
What if he doesn't drink? They never considered this.
That's
need
them.
A plan B.
Here we go.
We freaking drinks it. That's all I can say. Oh, she's so pretty.
Clever. Send the girl first. Don't let her play with your head, little brother.
Lady Forrester.
She's all right.
My apologies for arriving unannounced. I was hoping I might have a word in private with Asha.
She does want peace, though. She's not. She knows her father's not. Really. Doesn't agree with him.
I think we can agree these are not ideal circumstances.
Mm-hmm. Agreed.
But these are the circumstances we find ourselves in. I know how you must feel, Asha. What your family has suffered, it's unimaginable. Which is why the bloodshed must stop.
I agreed to your father's terms, didn't I?
You did. But I know you, Asha. You're not the one to roll over so easily.
She knows we got something in store.
You don't like being pushed into a corner. It's not in your nature.
I'm different now.
Things are different now. I'm different now. But you have nothing to worry about.
You were always a terrible liar. You have to understand.
I've risked everything to bring peace between our houses. To meet with Roderick in secret. To tell him of the traitor within these very walls.
Can't forget that.
To make sure no harm came to Ryan as our ward. All while persuading my father the bloodshed would end if we were to wed.
This is her idea.
No ulterior motive. No hidden agenda. Just peace.
Father worries me.
I'm sorry, but I don't trust your father. He ordered the ambush. It just as soon slit my throat as see us wed.
That was before. My father would never betray my trust.
It was like yesterday.
Truth be told, my father's scared of you.
Is what? He?
With Roderick, he knew who and what he was dealing with. But you, he thinks you're dangerous. You proved as much when you attacked his men.
They came after us.
I know. And that's all in the past now, I promise. We can make this work, Asha. This is our one chance. Together we can control the future of our houses. Just promise me, when my father and brother walk through that door, nothing will happen that could threaten that future. Our future. I need your assurance. Nothing will happen.
Fate will decide.
And at this point, it's in the hands of the gods.
Begging your pardon, my lord. I'm afraid Lady Forrester requires your help.
Of course.
I should go.
Should we have lied to her?
What she help might, does my mother need?
She might warn him now. Lord. I don't know.
It was the best I could think of. But we have everything in place. How should we proceed?
Ready the poison.
Ready the poison.
Of course, my lord.
She's gonna warn him and he's not gonna drink. He's gonna be cautious. He looks pretty sure of himself. Then again, he always looks like that.
Elissa, I'm sorry it's come to this, but at least it's done.
Where's my son?
Right to it then.
She looks messed up.
Oh, my baby.
Enough slobbering. You have him back when we've hammered out the details of your surrender.
Why are they always so rough to him?
Lord Whitehill.
Asher. Now, who'd ever have imagined this? You welcoming me into your hall to drink your wine and call me father.
You'll love the wine.
The last of you when Gregor shipped you off to the other side of the bloody world.
I humbly welcome you.
You honor us, Lord Whitehill, with your presence.
Don't overdo it.
Union.
Honor you? I didn't take you for an arse-licker, Forrester.
Father, don't bicker. Asher's showing you respect.
Somehow I doubt it.
What's with the smirk
would
on his face,
like
Tom?
Would you like to sit down, Lord Whitehill?
Aye. Get me something to drink. I'm bloody parched.
Oh, no problem with that.
Talia, how will you fetch the wine for his lordship?
Get a glass for Griff, too.
We thought you'd like to sit here, Lord Whitehill.
This is not gonna work.
I'll sit there. Thank you very much. In the lord's chair. It's not like your father wanted your worthless arse in it.
It's difficult.
Sit where you will, Lord Whitehill.
Oh, I said nothing,
there is space
I guess.
Enough for us all.
Lose your tongue, Forrester. Or did you forget again who the fuck I am?
Calm down, Father. Asha's just showing you the respect you deserve.
Guy's gonna give himself a heart attack with all this stress he's putting on himself. We should be so lucky. Look, he's all messed up. He's, like, scraped up.
So, Lord Forrester.
Oh, God, don't talk.
You made your way as a sellsword out there, did you? Hey, a little rape, a little murder. Anything for the right price.
Sellswords don't rape. They use their
sword. Your family must be so proud. And all those bed slaves a sellsword must enjoy across a narrow sea.
Oh, mind your manners,
I can't imagine
brother.
How my sister will be able to please you.
That's enough, Griff. We to be brothers. We to act like it.
Hated saying that.
Enough,
huh?
Bloody nattering.
These people are horrible.
Down, Griff, let's drink.
We can't be one with them. They're horrible, man. They're miserable people. You can see how unhappy they are, and that's why they pour it all over us like that. That
a toast.
Look weird.
We should make a toast.
Arr.
What shall we toast to?
To a trade glass or something.
Let's hear it. Don't make me sit here waiting to drink.
To our alliance.
Between our families, House Forrester and House Whitehill. Let us put the bloodshed behind us.
To our alliance. He didn't drink, did he?
No. This isn't right.
Oh, I knew it.
You first, then me. In the way of the North.
Uh-huh.
Forrester. Let's drink together as lords of our houses.
Can we flip around real fast?
Let me. Let it be you and I who seal this bond. For our houses. For our children.
Oh my god.